morning students. In last lecture we discuss about schedule number 3, in that we completely changes around us this lesson. So today we are going to start next schedule, schedule number 4. In this schedule number 4 we are going to learn a new chapter, that is the separation of substances. See, in these chapters we are going to perform a many practicals. Okay, see the name of this chapter, separation of substances. See, separation means in here what we have to do, we have to separate the two substances. See, before that we learn about a mixture. Mixture means what? Anyone recall it again? Mixture means what? If one or more substances we mix together and then it form a mixture. Okay, for example, anyone just write two examples of mixture, and you know that there are two types of mixture, that is homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Okay, now we don't think about the homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. When we will start the separation techniques, separation methods, that time we will see. Only just write two examples of mixture. Suppose now here we will take the mixture of rice and stone. See, rice, do you know raw rice? Okay, see in this petri dish there is a mixture of rice and stone. Okay, so here some unwanted things are there. Now which are unwanted things? Stone. Okay, because stones are not good for our health, it is a harmful for us. Okay, so how to separate this? What we will do? See, the rice color is different and the stone color is different. So we can separate this very easily by hand. Okay, see, now I will separate these stones by using my hand. So this is known as a separation. Okay, so do you understand the separation? One more example. See, suppose your mother prepare a pulao. Okay, in that the so many ingredients she used. Now which ingredients she used? See, rice, then tomatoes, carrot, okay, onion, then some peanuts and all. See, this all students, not like this, all the materials, whatever the she use ingredients in that. Okay, so while eating, what we are doing? We are separating some things. Now suppose I don't like a peanut, so I will separate that peanut. Since I will pick up the peanuts and I can keep in another side. Okay, so this is only known as a separation. Okay, so here see, a mixture is a substance. Mixture means what? A mixture is a substance that contains two or more pure substances mixed together in a different proportion. Means, see, in two or more substances mixed together in a different proportion, that is only known as a mixture. Okay. Now, next point, see, the substances that are mixed to form mixture are called the constituents or components. Means which substances, okay, see, which substances that are mixed together. Okay, now for example, just now we see the example, rice and what? Stone. Okay, now see here the two different substances, rice is different and stones different. Okay, when these two substances mix together to form a mixture. Okay, so these two substances are known as a constituent or component. See here, the substance that are mixed to form mixture. Now which substance? Here example, rice and stones. Okay, are called the constituents or components. So do you understand the meaning of constituent and components? So rice and stone are known as a constituent or component. Here for example I given. Okay, now another example, just you see any one example you tell me. Okay, good. Now which is another example? See, salt and water. Okay, so in that which two substances? One is a salt and another one is a water. Okay, now these are all the things we have to separate it, but there are some different methods are there. added methods we will learn in this chapter. But before to start the methods of separation, what is a need for separation? Means why we are separating these other things? What is the need? See, behind each and everything there is a science. Yes, do you know that? Because now you are learning science from third standard and before that learning years also. So now we will see the need for the separation. Why we have to separate the things? First one is to remove harmful substances. The first need to remove harmful substances. See, whenever we purchase some things, there may be pulses, okay, all the things in that, the some unwanted substances are there, and that substances are very harmful for us. If we will not separate that, they may be cause of many diseases if we will eat that substance, okay. So what the first purpose to remove harmful substances? In this example only, see, now rice and there are many stones are there. If we will not separate this, then what will happen? We will suffer for many diseases. So what this is the need, means this harmful stone harmful for us. So these we are going to separate it, okay. So this is the first need. Now secondly, to obtain useful components. Now see, this is a correlated to this point. Now here the harmful substance we separated, and when we separated the harmful substances, what we will get? Useful component. Okay, now in this example only, when you will just separate this harmful substance, then what will be the remain here? Useful substance. Okay, so these two points are related to each other. Means whenever we are separating any substance, harmful substance, then the remaining that is useful for us. Then the third point is to remove undesirable substances. Now to remove undesirable substances, see here the word is undesirable. Do you remember something undesirable? In last lecture we have learned that is the undesirable change, means which one we don't like it, which are the unwanted changes. Okay, the same meaning is here. To remove undesirable substances means which one we don't want. Means undesirable substances, which one we don't want, that we are removing. So because of these three reasons, and many reasons are there, because of these three reasons, we are going to separate the substances. Okay, now the next point that we know, that is the method of separation. So now the next point we will see, that is the methods of separation. See, before means we learned that what is the need for separation. Okay, now this the all the substances how to separate, which methods we are going to use for the separation. Okay, the now first point we will see, that is the separation of solid substances from a mixture. Now first point we will see, that is the separation of solid substances. Now solid, liquid, gases, these all are the states, okay. Do you know that all the states, okay. So when more than the two substances, both are solid. See, yeah, both are solid. So before we see the example, that is rice and stone. Now rice and stone, both are in which state? Solid state, okay. So how to separate such a substances? Means both the substances are solid, and to form a mixture, how to separate, that some methods we are going to learn now. So first method is, that is a hand picking. See, it's a very easy method, hand picking method. See here, now what? Here rice, some raw rice and some stones are there, okay. And then now just I will pick up the stone, see, and I will separate this. Means all the stones I can separate by using this method. So this is known as a which method? Hand picking method. See, but when this method is used for, okay, when see here the size, shape or color of the unwanted substances is different from that of the useful one. Now see, here rice and the stone, the both the color is different. right? So we can easily recognize, means this black color are stones, so we can separate it. Means whenever in the mixture there are the two different colors or different many colors, okay? So that time only you can use this hand picking method, okay? Now the next point, see, the quantity of the mixture is small. Now quantity of a mixture, now see, here a very little amount, means small amount I taken the rice and stone. The quantity is small, so easily we can separate this. But suppose there are, the quantity is more, okay? Means more than, suppose 1 kg, 2 kg, 4 kg rice, if I will give you to the separate, then how much time it need to separate the unwanted things? It need a more time to separate this, okay? So for that time, it is not a useful method, okay? Then now next, it is C. So when this hand picking method is useful, if the quantity is small and the shape, size and color, both the substances is different, that time only this method is useful for us. Understood the hand picking method? Very simple hand is to pick the unwanted thing and separate it. That method is known as a hand picking method. Now the next method is there, that is a threshing. Okay, another next method, that method is known as a threshing. Now hand picking method, do you understand? See here one picture I shown you, just to see that picture, it is very simple one. This method you can apply at your home also, okay? Now the second method is there, that is a threshing. The process of separating grains from the stalk by beating them on the ground or using a machine is called as a threshing. Now threshing means what? To separate the grains by a stalk. Okay, see here the picture is shown here how this man is doing. It is he is beating that stalk. Why? Because he want to separate that grains from a stalk. Okay, means we need only grains, so we have to separate them. And this is the manual method, which one shown here in this picture. This is a manual method. Okay, means by hand we are doing this, okay? But if it is a more amount of, it is there, then that time we can use machines also. That machine is known as a thresher, okay? What is the name of that machine? Thresher. So the threshing means what? The process of separating grains from the stalk by beating them on the ground by using a machine is called as a threshing. Okay, so do you understand these two methods? The first one is hand picking and second one is a threshing. So today, this whatever the points are written on this board, just write down in your chemistry notebook, and homework is to read this lesson, okay, and write more examples in this hand picking method, means where we will use the hand picking method. Write some examples of mixture. Thank you.